In this video, we'll look at two things. One is, what is solar panel efficiency? And the second is, how much does it matter? So first thing, solar panel efficiency, what is it? Solar panel efficiency refers to the amount of the sunlight or radiation that falls on a solar panel that the panel is able to convert into usable electricity. So the most efficient solar panel on the market, say a SunPower X22 series, you know, is probably, I think in the order of 22.7% efficiency. So what that means is that effectively 22% of the energy that's in the sunlight, the radiation energy that's within the sunlight that falls on that panel, it's able to convert to electricity. A cell developed, just a cell, it hasn't become a panel yet, by the National Renewable Energy Labs in Colorado, that in, I think was 38% efficient. There are advancements all the time, but at the moment in production standard panels, you know, the most efficient currently approved panel is around 22.7. There's quite a lot of the good tier one brands that are around 19.5 to 21. And you know, a couple of the big Chinese manufacturers have actually announced that they've developed cells that are also around the 22, 22.5 percent efficiency level, and they'll probably be available in their production models in late 2021, I would have thought. That's what solar panel efficiency is. It's the measure of how much of the energy a panel receives it can turn into usable electricity. The next question that really matters is, how important is that? And when is it important? Is it always important? Is it important sometimes? Now, I would argue that solar panel efficiency is not as important as it is often sort of hyped up to be by solar salesmen. The reason I would say that is because the way they measure efficiency of a panel is they shine, you know, a kilowatt of solar energy or of radiation at a solar panel at 25 degrees Celsius, and they measure what proportion of that energy that panel is able to, you know, convert into electricity. So that's how they measure standard test conditions. Based on that, they'll then rate a panel at a certain wattage. That's a 360 SunPower here, and this is a 360 LG over here. Now, slightly different efficiencies, but these panels will produce the same amount of power, all things being equal, about the other specs of the panel in terms of things like temperature coefficient and the like, which does vary slightly between these panels. SunPower also has a very good temperature coefficient, which means that as it heats up, its output degrades slower than a different panel that has a slightly different temperature coefficient. But the main thing to note about that is, you know, these panels may well have different cells of different efficiency within them, but they're both 360 watt panels, which means in the same amount of sunlight pointed on them at 25 degrees Celsius, they'll produce exactly the same amount of power. So if we extrapolate that out, and we're talking about an average residential size system of say 8 or 10 kilowatts or whatever, then, you know, if you have a 10 kilowatt system, you're quoted with a 22% efficient panel, and a 10 kilowatt system, you're quoted with a 20% efficient panel, then those two systems will produce exactly the same amount of power because the efficiency is already taken into account in the rating of the panel at a certain wattage. So what that means is, what's it really worth? And where, you know, why is efficiency really worth more? Now, the only time when that efficiency is really of value to you is when you have a limited space on your roof. If you have the same 10 kilowatt system using these two different panels of different efficiency. The only difference will be the one that's more efficient will be a slightly smaller footprint. If the two panels of different efficiency receive the same amount of sunlight, so they're sitting in the same plane, same atmospheric conditions, same amount of sunlight, the two 360 watt panels of different efficiencies will produce the same amount of power, but the 360 watt panel that's most efficient will take up a slightly smaller, in that case, a 10% smaller footprint. So that is a value where you have a very tight roof space, because it may be the difference between getting 10 kilowatts on your roof and 11 kilowatts. However, for most people, either you don't need that size system to power your house, or you have more than enough roof space to power it. And so I would argue that for most people, it's not worth paying a huge premium for efficiency. And that's really the point of this, the point I wanted to make, and the reason I made this video is because, all things being equal, efficiency is good. More efficient, I guess, is better, because it's no more power. My 10 kilowatt array is still the same amount of power, but it's slightly smaller, I guess. So that's kind of nice. But it's not worth paying a massive premium for, because it really doesn't matter that much. So that's what I have to say about solar panel efficiency. If you go to solarreviews.com and then type solar panel efficiency, you'll find articles that go into this topic in more detail. As always, we recommend people going over to our website and using our online solar calculator. It will, from just your address, your power spend, it will work out how many solar panels you would need to offset your bill. It'll even show them to you on your roof. And it can also get estimates from one of the many great local family-owned solar companies around the country. I think there's 600 or 700 solar companies that we have that provide quotes through our site. So these guys, you know a lot about solar, and you know, most of them are great companies that will give you a great service, and you'll enjoy dealing with them. So all the best for now. Goodbye.